Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to another episode of ETS2. Today we're going to have a look A at the Iberia, B we're going to have here the start of the video right now with me building this truck here up to my specs. We have $260,000. I think I can make that happen. I just sold the truck that I was running the whole time for Iberia. Keep in mind, this is my single player profile, which is grossly neglected because I'm so much on Truck SMP. That being said, let's get into the building phase. Dear friends, and with that, I say now for real, hello and welcome. Today, of course, as you know, or as you already seen, today the new T-Line was released. And yeah, we are the first ones to drive this thing in ETS. If you think about it, it's kind of insane because, well, in real life, we can't get this one yet. But in here, we can already drive it. So that being said, I would say we're gonna see to it that we get to Iberia and find the load and get driving. So the freight market holds for us the following 17 tons of car batteries, and I think to make it a little bit more interesting, we're going to haul those in a curtain side B double. Or in a curtain side double. What should we do? B double? Or curtain side double? Curtain side double. Double double. So you can see we are going from Barcelona to Valladolid. Up or Valladolid. No, Valladolid, I think. And so we're gonna pick that up here. And then we're gonna have time to talk. So you've seen my specs on this truck. And it is absolutely amazing to me. It honestly is. The fact that, yeah, we can drive this truck before people can drive it in real life. Time to do our walk around. Make sure that everything that is supposed to be black and round is black and round, and everything that's supposed to light up is lighting up. That's all good. That's all good. All good. I like those new turn signals. Are they actually... Are they sequential? Oh, they are sequential! Nice! Love it. Alright, tuck test is done. So, I'd say... We better get going here. Just like that. I tell you one thing though. In Spain, as well as in Portugal, they sure like their roundabouts. There is no doubt about that. I'm gonna make sure here that we don't get hit by a train. Oh, I love the sound of this engine. And then you look at the lighting conditions in 140 and it's just, yeah. You can see this is indeed our new truck, because we have only 2 kilometers now. It even smells new. That'll change though, because we have an air freshener in here, and my preferred weapon of choice when it comes to air fresheners is always vanilla. I don't know why. Ever since I had my first car, I would never wanted air fresheners in my car, but now keep in mind that I did indeed smoke for a long time. Like, I haven't smoked now in forever. I quit smoking now. No. That's not true. And 12 years ago? 13 years ago? Somewhere around there. And, so it's really not an issue anymore, but it's still to this day. Like, if I put the air fresheners in the car, or in my truck, it's always vanilla. What's your preferred air freshener, if you have any? Let me know in the comments below, I'm curious. One of those things that you really never think about. Alright. This one is a little bit longer than a normal. Than a normal average trailer. What you will see now is the improved behavior of AI when you are merging in and off traffic. Unfortunately, from what I've noticed so far, this only applies to the rebuild series, or the rebuild parts of the map, as well as okay, it's free for lane, so it doesn't matter anyway. But yeah, it only applies to the new part, i.e. Spain, as well as the rebuild areas of Euro Truck Simulator. I noticed that in Frankfurt there are quite some problems yet, and I'll have to deal with that. So we'll work on that, hopefully. Well, not we will work on that, but SES will work on that, hopefully, in in further reiterations and updates. But it definitely, it really is noticeable when you drive here in Iberia. And it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful update. It honestly is. Or the DLC. I have been driven... I have driven these roads for what, 18, 19 hours now? Since I was given early access, and my goodness, it's truly, once again, made my decision here a little bit late. Sorry. But yeah, I have driven here quite a bit, and it, once again, SES just raised the bar a little bit more with this DLC, for sure. I know there's a lot of you guys that are not gonna watch this before the release, just because they don't want to see anything of Iberia before they, before they get their hands on it. But take heart, it's only 3 more days. On the 8th is when it's released. Oh, actually, no, sorry, it's 2 more days. It's 2 more days until you can get your hands. You get your hands on this one. We shouldn't have any problems with fuel. Oh, Porta de Barcelona. We shouldn't have any problems with fuel here, because this version of the Renault has the extended fuel tanks, so we can really go the extra mile, so to speak. And this is what you get from trying to show people things and stuff. Yeah, I'm gonna be hitting the cruise control here. How do you like the new cockpit on this truck? This, by the way, acts a lot faster. You can easily go through here doing 40. No problems with that. Yeah, the traffic I noticed, and the best way to describe it is the traffic is a lot more assertive. Not aggressive, but really assertive when it comes to merging in and out of traffic. Which is good, because as you guys know, in the past, this used to be a problem. And now it is not anymore. I'm not catching up with you anymore. Cool. Alright, I guess we're gonna go and drive manual, not cruise control here. what's happening here. Oh. Huh? Ambulant, yeah. Ambulance, yeah.
Krankenwagen!
If you guys know that video, it's just too good. Everything in German has to be yelled. Sorry if I just startled you. But... oh, look, only 500 more clicks. Well, the first 500 clicks on this truck we're gonna be sharing together here with this video. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess more like 600 and some. Hey, look, he speeds up, pulls in, and whoosh, off he goes. Bye-bye. Curious how far the reach is on a tank. Oh wow, look at this. 3,800 kilometers. Weird. Yeah, this was... it's my loan. You could say I wrecked my last load and truck and lost a whole bunch of money, and this is a fairly new profile with not much money made yet. What is this? Oh, it's an excavator. I see. Yeah, I wish you would. Oh, I bet you wish you had a nice Renault like I do here. Those are usually words that don't go in the same sentence with a lot of you guys. Nice Renault, but I really have to say I like this truck. It sounds good. You sit super high up. You have really good visibility all around. Ah, well. Even with all my stuff here. And as you know, the Legend King Trucker King Legend has to have his little flags there in the window otherwise. And this is funny, this is really funny. I talked about this in a stream or two ago, is that initially when the accessory DLC came out, cap accessory DLC, I bought it because it was $2 and it was the initial release was for a good cause. And well, at that point, I also didn't have the connections to SES that I have these days. But I said on that stream, that very night, I said, there is no way I will ever use anything out of this. This is nonsense, and blah, blah, blah. And I want nothing dangling in the truck and on my windshield. And it just drives me insane. Yeah. Fast forward, what, 4 years? And here we are. With the windshield full of stuff. I don't know how that all happened, but I guess my taste when it comes to dangly stuff on my windshield changed. That was open. I guess the visual was faster than the actual truck. That's unfortunate. Brand new truck and already dinged up. I'm actually surprised that, for the fact that this is a new truck, that they still have traditional mirrors. Although the mirrors I really like with this convex, they show quite a bit what's going on behind you. So we're gonna be trying to park this thing just interior view. However, on the Iberia DLC so far, I can tell you one thing. I have the difficulty set too high when it comes to, or too advanced when it comes to the parking spots. And so far, I have to tell you, there has not been one parking spot that was straightforward. Like, I'm not even talking about driving it backing up around the 90 or something like that. No, they are in all kinds of angles. You can be certain that somebody left a container or a car or a truck or some weird other thing in the way, so there is no way you could just pull in or even just back in straight. Even with this combination, I found myself more often than not to have back in around corners and stuff like that, which is awesome because it really it ups the level of difficulty for sure. But at the same time, if you are not used to it or if you are new to the game, you do not want to drive through Iberia and have the setting on high, because it will throw you some pretty tough cookies your way. I don't know why I used cookies. I could have used bones, I could have used anything. But cookies was what was on my mind, I guess. And if you are still watching at this point, well, then of course you are one of here. Now, see, this is what I meant here, by the way. If you just paid attention to that vehicle, that silver one pulling in, the advanced AI behavior when it comes to on ramps and off ramps, really, really visible here. Now we're coming past Pamplona. It's just so nice. Oh, actually, it's just our off-ramp. Didn't even realize that. Did you just honk at me? That sounded like he honked at me. Huh. Don't know what I think about that. Another toll booth. They sure like those too, yeah. Which is okay. It's just funny. I wonder how many times trucks went through the wrong lane before they installed these huge yellow signs. Like, there is no way that you go into the wrong lane now, because you're gonna be wrecking stuff. And if you are still watching at this point, then of course you are one of my long-time viewers or a new viewer that is intrigued by what he sees. In that case, let me welcome you. If you are one of my long-time viewers, then thank you so much for your continued support. You know, I tweeted this morning that yesterday when I was streaming, we were setting up a new farm in Farming Simulator, and I was just doing my thing and whatnot, and there were. It was a fairly good stream. It was like 140, 150 people watching. And just, you know, it really hit me for the first time that this is the job. This is what I'm doing. This is what you guys allow me to do on a daily basis. Creating content for you and... And yeah, really a lot. What is this? Bed? That was probably not Guardia Civil. I don't know what that was. But yeah, it really hit me yesterday during the stream, really, how fortunate I am to be able to do this and how grateful I am to you guys. And that being said, if you are not already and you have the possibility, then consider becoming a member of the channel. There is the entry levels that started at $1.99 per month, and it's just, it helps. Every single bit helps and ensures that this channel is staying on the air and I can keep doing this full time. Do I want to get rich? No, but I do want to make sure that I can take care of my family and, that here means that we are... What is this with the red police cars? Like, I never noticed that, to be honest with you. Ooh, dude. I have the feeling that load was not from Pfizer. Leave a comment down below if you get this reference. Oh no. So I have to go through this toll booth and then through another one. Yeah, I know it's 40. I was going 48. Give me a break. Also, for those of you that don't know that, I stream now on YouTube again daily. Every morning from 8:30 to 9:30 my time. And then from noon until 4 p.m. Oh, sorry. Mondays to Fridays, 8:30 to 9:30. And every day. From noon till 4 p.m. And then, of course, there is my evening streams at 9:30 to 2:30. And that is, of course, all mountain time. I can only suggest that you don't know what time that would be. Just type either mountain time to UTC or mountain time to whatever time zone you are in Google. That will tell you exactly what time the stream starts. Also on YouTube, the nice thing is that streams are scheduled, so they will pop up as scheduled live streams if you click on the live tab, and that will tell you exactly when it starts. My, oh my. Sure looks amazing. I wonder how many kilometers this is now gonna add to our road. This might just push it over the limit that I have for videos at the moment. Because this added another 150 on that detour. And there is only so much time I can spend these days on a video, just because I have to record so and so many videos and then I have to be live. So we might not be able to finish this this very run. Oh wow. That's where they built the wind generators. There's probably one or two nice loads for us. Yeah, friends, I'm afraid that once we get into the next town where I can park, this will be the end. now we might as well then drive into the city and have a look. Because I don't think I have ever done that. Plus I can grab fuel. Well, I don't really need fuel. We just burned through barely an eighth of a tank. And keep in mind, this is a fairly heavy load, especially for the size of engine that we have. Pamplona discovered. Beautiful. All right. Well, friends, this be it for now. I do hope you enjoyed the episode, and leave me a comment down below what you think about it. Until next time, Mr. Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.